Now let's install the Java development kit. You could simply Google JDK download and you will get a list of all the results. Now you might be thinking, what is this black bar do I have over here? This is something really useful if you are developing programs and you simply want to do a Google search and you want to see the result which a number of other developers might have put in this particular tool. Then you can install this extension which is called grepa. So once you install this extension in your Google Chrome, over here it would look like this, and then you know it could simply, once it has access to your web page, it could simply always understand what you're searching for and give you the relevant results. So you could use that, because I use that a lot. Now when you check for JDK, you would be given the first result, which would be the Oracle website. Oracle has bought Sun Systems quite a few years ago, and that's why it has all the Java documentation and all the Java libraries and all the Java downloads as well. So right now, the latest version for the SE platform is Java SE 15. So what do I mean by SE? So there are different versions or different editions of Java which would work for different types of applications. The first is Java SE, which we just saw, which is known as Java Standard Edition. Another is Java EE, which is known as Java Enterprise Edition. This one is generally used to create enterprise applications, which comes with a lot more features and a lot more use cases for enterprise-based applications. Then you would have Java ME, which is the Java Micro Edition. You would also have Java FX, which is generally used to create user interfaces. But generally, we would use Java SE only. And then, if you really want to upgrade yourself, you could check out how you could use Java EE and its some various constructs like annotations and all of that. So Java EE is really the superset of Java SE. So let's go ahead and start working on Java SE, and you should be able to do everything which you require, unless and until your company or your code really uses Java EE, which you want to make sure that you know. So now let's go ahead and download the JDK, which is available for the latest release, which is Java SE 15 at the time of recording this particular video. Now you would obviously have to find out which operating system to install this on. Why do you think I really have to choose an operating system? Why could it not have been a common thing for all the operating systems? Can you guess? The reason for that is we want it to work on different operating systems to convert our common code to that particular operating system's machine code, right? So we would really require this particular development kit for our particular OS. So right now I'm working on the Windows machine, so I would just install JDK for Windows. Now once you install Java, you would find in your C drive in program files, a folder is created called Java. Then when you get into Java, you would find the JDK folder installed over here. Now you might be thinking, why it is JDK 14 and not 15? Just because I have already installed 14. So after installation, you would see JDK 15 installed, or any JDK which is the latest current version while you download that. So the whole idea is that your JDK folder would be created over here. Within this JDK, you would find a number of folders. The most important is bin, because that's where your Java executable lies. That's where your Java compiler lies. So this folder is very important. You simply have to now check this entire path, copy that, and you really want to update the environment variables of your operating system. Now, whatever procedure I'm talking about is for Windows, but that same procedure can be applied for a macOS or for Linux as well. Now, if you just check how to set environment variables, you would see over here, edit environment variables. Now, you can just come over here and check the path property, the path variable here, and then you can click on edit. So as you can see, I have set the C drive program files Java JDK 14 bin over here. If you obviously cannot see that for the first time, then you have to create a new and then paste it over there and simply do an OK, which would update that path variable. So right now I don't have to do that because it is already updated. Again, for system variables, you'd find this variable Java underscore home. create that variable and make sure that its name is java underscore home. Again, paste your JDK path over here. And again, in the path variable over here, you will find that it is the one which is updated from here. So that's all about setting environment variables. The next thing which you want to do is to actually install Eclipse. So you can simply type Eclipse download. Again, you would be given the first link as eclipse.org. That's the place where you want to go. And then you have to check the latest option which you have. So here there is this Eclipse IDE 2020.12 which we have over here. You could also check the other offerings which they have, but we could simply just download this IDE or whichever latest IDE you would have at that point of time. So you could download it over here, but I have already installed Eclipse in my system. So I'll just go ahead and show to you how the Eclipse folder would look like after you have installed that. So this Eclipse folder is really on my desktop because I've just put it over there, and simply you can open that and check for the application file of Eclipse, and you can just open that. So once your Eclipse is open, you could see something like this. Obviously, you would not have all these projects over here because I've been working a lot on Eclipse, but you would essentially not see this Projects Explorer. So you could go to File, New, and then you have all these various options. So don't worry about not being able to understand all the options. That you have something known as Java project, you could create the Java project, and I'll just create the name to be Java short course. And this is how I would generally name things, and this is how you should generally name things. Now here it is asking, what JRE do you want to use? So let's just use the default JRE, which is coming with the JDK 14, right? And we'll do a next. Now we'll see that a Java short course project is created, and it really has the SRC folder over here. And there's nothing within the SRC folder, okay? So we'll leave all the options as it is, and we will click on finish. So now this is how one project for our Java is created. And you can see over here that it has all the system libraries which is imported from the JDK which we just installed. And these are all the libraries which are really very important for us to work with Java with ease. So we don't have to worry about that. I want to do some sort of networking. First, I should just, you know, install the library and then work on that. No. Or I want to do some logging. First, let me just, you know, install those things. So all the common things are already there for us just because of JDK. And now all we have to do is create a new program in our SRC folder. This is the source folder where all of our Java code would lie. Okay. Now let's try to write our very first Java program. First, we will understand a little more about the Eclipse IDE. We'll try to run that Java program actually on the terminal, on the shell, and then we will see how we could, you know, make our program a little readable by adding comments. And then finally, I'm going to show you how we could actually do some sort of debugging if we land into problems in our code.